You know, when I bought a kayak, the one thing I was worried about was I was going to fall off of it. How was I going to get back on? I did a lot of research online. There are a lot of things that teach you how to get back on the kayak. There's a lot of different techniques and these kind of things, but I'm going to be honest, all of these guys are kind of smaller. However, if you're a big guy like me, getting on and off of that thing can be kind of a pain. I had to go fall off my kayak. There was no other way of doing it. Unfortunately, my swimming pool is the Gulf of Mexico. So I had to have somebody with me to help me get back up on it if I failed, or at least get me back to shore if I failed. Don't ever try this the first time without having somebody with you, unless you're in a swimming pool or unless you're in a really small pond or something like that. But if you're in open water of any kind, get a buddy. So I've come up with a technique for a bigger person to get on a kayak that I think pretty much anybody can do. Trust me, if I can do it, anybody can do it. So let's take a look at it. Most of the time when you fall off your kayak's gonna flip all the way over. You're gonna lose your gear. Everything's gonna go rampant crazy. Stay calm. Number one thing, relax, stay calm. You have to make sure you look around and understand whether or not you're in any more danger. So the first thing you have to do is you have to upright that kayak. Don't try to recover your gear. It may be, oh, it's sinking, it's precious. You need to get back on that kayak as soon as possible. If you're a bigger person like this, and you're in open water, and you're treading, and you're panicking, and your heart rate's going up, chances are you're not in real good physical condition. You're not going to be able to swim very long. You're not going to be able to hold yourself up very long. Sure, we float. We float well. As a matter of fact, it's hard to sink us. I know, I scuba dive, so I get that. But we run out of gas very quickly. So you have to flip that thing over. Flipping the kayak over isn't as hard as one would think it is. Almost every kayak that I have seen has some kind of handle on the side of it, on either side of it. So all you have to do is grab the handle, grab the other handle underneath, and push one up and pull one down. So you push one up away from you and you pull one towards you. And what that's going to do is that's going to invert that kayak and turn it over for you. The second issue is you have to recover yourself. How do you get back up on there? Now, here's the thing. I've tried almost every way I could figure out that would work for me to get back up on it. I've tried going from the front. That didn't work. I will tell you, when I didn't have my PFD on, I could get up on the front. But when I put my PFD on, I could not get up on the front. It was impossible for me to do so. I've tried to get on it from the side. The way I've seen just about everybody that gets on a kayak, that's how they get back on the kayak. They just get on the side, they lift themselves up, they flip themselves over. Easy peasy, right? No. So I had a couple of different things that didn't work, but I had to find something that did work. So what was it that was going to work for me? When I was trying to get up on the front, I accidentally discovered something. Almost every kayak has some kind of foothold in it. It's either got the ribs in the side where you can put your feet, or it's got pedals, or it's got something there. The best thing to do is to, with your right hand, put it on the nose of the kayak. If you have a handle, awesome, grab that handle. If you don't have a handle and a note, just put it on the nose of the kayak to where you can grab a hold of it in some fashion. The next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna take your other hand and you're gonna reach up and you're gonna go toward a little bit towards the side of the kayak and you're gonna grab up there and you're gonna push down. Now here's the interesting thing about a kayak. It's like a buoy aboard in the water. When you push the back down, the front comes up. When you push the port side down, the starboard side comes up, and so on and so forth. When you push that down, the back end comes up. That's good, because the more the back end comes up, the more the front end goes into the water. The more the front end goes into the water, the easier it's going to be for you to recover yourself. So you push down, and when you do, you're gonna push the whole kayak under your chest. You're gonna push it under your chest, under your belly. You're not gonna try and lift yourself up onto the kayak. That's where a lot of people make mistakes. They try to put themselves on the kayak. Don't put yourself on the kayak, put the kayak under you. It's way easier. Once you get to that position, all you're gonna do is release your right hand. At the same time, you're gonna move your right leg over the nose of the kayak. By doing this, you've now distributed over half of your weight onto the nose of the kayak. So now you're basically straddling the kayak. Okay, so you're back on your kayak in the sit position. Now what? Take a break. Stop. Collect your thoughts. Catch your breath. At this point, you're probably a little bit worn out, not only from panicking, because let's face it, when you turn over in a kayak and you're not expecting it, you panic. So at this point, just relax for a second, collect yourself, and catch your breath, because the next step is going to need you to be level-headed. The next step you have to do is you have to basically just crawl up the kayak. You just lean your hands forward and you crawl up the kayak. You want to end up with your knees inside the gunwales. That's the ideal spot. Once you get there, it gets a little bit tricky. And by tricky, I mean balance. This is where a lot of people will have to practice to make sure that you keep your center of balance. When you're standing up straight and you lean over, if you're standing up straight and you lean the top of your body over, you're gonna lean that way or you're gonna fall. If you do this way, it's the same thing. On a kayak, it's even worse. A kayak's hull is designed for everything to stay right in the center for its stability. So as long as you're in the center, you're fine. If at this point you start to lean one side or the other, you're going to go back off the kayak. You're going to have to do this all over again. Here's what you do. You lean your hands forward in the seat. You take whatever knee you're going to spin. In other words, if I'm going to turn this way, I want to use this knee. If I'm going to turn this way, I want to use this knee. Imagine you're inside a little tube or a tunnel and you have to turn. Whichever way you naturally want to turn, you're going to want to use that knee first. And you're going to put this knee right in the middle of the kayak. I put mine in the cup holder. The cup holder on just about every kayak I've ever seen is a dead center in the middle of the kayak. I remember when I used to wrestle, we had to do all these really strange drills. One of the moves that we did was called a sit out. And basically you just kicked your leg out and you sat on your butt. This is kind of like that, except a sit out, when you come out, you stand up like this and you come out, you sit like this. You're not going to do that because now where's your center of gravity? It's back here. On a kayak, your center of gravity is in the middle. So we want to stay in the middle. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your turning knee, you're going to place it in the middle, take your non-turning knee in the back, and you're going to put it straight back behind that foot. Notice, I'm in one line, straight center all the way down in one line. My center of gravity is right in the middle of the kayak. And this is the fun part. You're going to have to take this hand, and move them to the center. Then you're going to gently move this hand over a little bit, and this part has to be done very quickly. You're going to turn your whole body in that direction, just like that. Now this has to be done very quickly for a couple of reasons. Reason number one, if you do it slow, it takes your center of balance off. If you do it slow, it's gonna get cumbersome. If you do it quickly, it helps to throw your body. I'm a big guy and I can still do this. Not hard to do. So bam, bam, you're in all fours. You put your knee up, you straighten yourself out. And then all you're gonna do is you're gonna put your hand here and you're gonna sit. Now, if you're in a kayak like mine, you're gonna put this hand on top of the seat. kind of up on the seat because you're going to sit in the seat. So you're going to get lined up, and you're going to have your hand here, and then you're going to just turn it and sit in the seat. Good job. Now you're back on your yak. Go get your stuff, get back to fishing or exploring or whatever it is you're doing. If this helped you out, hit the like button. If it's gonna help somebody else, share it. You got a better way of doing it, comment below. If you wanna see more, subscribe. Now get back to work. That was for all you wonderful subscribers. We love you guys. My goodness, I appreciate you guys so much. I know it was goofy and ugly. You know what? I don't care. You guys thought enough to come over and be with us in our channel. I don't mind being a little goofy. Thanks again.